Okay, so what we want to do is, as we dial this guy along, make sure we got the angle pretty close. We want that to read zero. See how that's flattened out. Let's just take it. Come back to zero again. As we come along, we want to keep adjusting this till we get to zero. So. Should have locked it. Now I'm causing myself problems. Let's get it back in there. Okay. Right, quite a say 2.5 there. It's too out of whack.
Just under 2.
This popped it.
When you unlocked it, it moved.
There, dude.
Hello.
Not disturbing it at all this time.
Gonna happen.
I think we gotta leave that alone. So this is way off. You can see, to make a comment, that the guys that used this lathe before I bought it weren't tradesmen. They treated it like shit. That's why a lot of things were rusted and slowly bringing it back to life. So we're going to want to position this. We're going to want to lock that. The only thing we're going to be using is this. supposed to go. So we bring that in here. What we can do. Gotta get about there. You may have it. This is a good sign. So I'm bringing this around. I'm letting the weight of it go that way. That way you're always pushing it in. For some reason these just don't feel right. See, I can see it. This is actually, I want to take a bit of this off. I knurled this just for yucks. Seems to be okay. And I'm happy that we actually have support in here. By the time I get in there, right down at the bottom, we can still use this guy. Beat her up a little bit. Prepared to offset the tailstock, then we use the power feed and probably get a better surface from this. Time. So we're shooting for, this end is pretty close to that diameter, that's what I machined it to. This end is the one we're going to have to use to control, and of course, set anything up before I came here, and for some reason this is feeling tight. There, we got 0.829. So, if you want to take this down 10 thou, and then we'll verify. So,
0.0510.
Yeah. So take it 10 thou.
10 thou is 1/4.
Yeah. So what I've done is I got to here, then I advanced back and bring it back here.
So I'll bring it to 11.
And then, yep.
11.5.
To 11.5, touch, then use this. Because this is what we're using to gauge our measurement. So we don't want to be setting it here one time, then back here the next time. We can fucking throw this all over. Starting to get that surface finish a lot tighter now, so I'm going to jump her up a speed notch. Okay. I'm going to get a tool post grinder. Basically, it's a cylindrical grinding device that we put in here. I feel that's a lot.
It's better. It still sits in the lines, though.
Yeah, but we want to make sure that we get a nice. Coming all the way out. My rubbing of the glue in there is not consistent, so. Which is good, it means the tool's going to grab. Going to pull that. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. That's what you want. Because remember, this is gonna be taking force. So I'm reluctant to
take any more off.
Yeah, right now.
Try to buffer up a little bit.
It is working, right?